teacher training with kids intelligence. So just imagine a situation where you are stuck in an island for the rest of your life. You don't have anything with you, nothing. There are people. You will be trading with people, but you have nothing to calculate it with. And you only know digits from 0 to 9. So there are people who are producing goods in hundreds, thousands, and so on. But how will you end up calculating? You don't have any calculator, you don't have any computer, nothing, no paper, no pen. Can anyone tell me how would you stand there and calculate 1102 plus 2340 plus 3800 and whatever? Can anyone tell me how would you do that?
Very difficult.
You don't know, you just know digits from 0 to 9. Nothing at all. We don't know how to calculate post that. So similarly, in around 300 BC, the same problem was going on. There were traders who were producing more and more goods, but they didn't have any means to calculate their production, to calculate their earnings, nothing at all. Then one day what happened? Where people would live, the civilization was not that developed. So we were surrounded with a lot of sand everywhere. So what people started doing was they started making beads on sand. Now they started using these sand beads as some sort of calculation. So they had different, they didn't know that it was from 0 to 9. They would call these digits as something else. But if we sit and think about it, they only knew digits from 0 to 9. So on the basis of these beads, they started calculating. Hence, so they came up with a word ABX, abex. Now abex is a Latin word which means sand. So this is a word which is used for sand calculations, ABX. Then gradually, as and when evolution took place, there was a word, the Germans came up with the word as abacon, A-B-A-K-O-N. Now this abacon was a tabular form of calculation. So any calculation that was done through tables, it was called abacon. Now abacus is a mixture of abex and abacon because it is a frame which is tabular in nature and consists of beads. So that is how we came up with the whole concept of abacus. So today my topic is introduction of abacus. I'll be talking about introduction of abacus and how does it help a child in the development. Okay. So as I told, there were only 9 digits available for counting. Hence it became very difficult for the traders. Now after the sand calculation came up, people started using stones and sheep to calculate because again the number of beads was restricted to 9. But with stones and sheep, the problem was we didn't have unlimited stones available, we didn't have unlimited sheep available. Hence they had to come up with something that could go on till the digits that we know. So now we know counting till zillion. So hence on this abacus you can solve till zillion. So that is how the evolution of abacus started. First abacus wasn't horizontal, it was a vertical setup. Then gradually people realized that when it is vertical, you cannot fit in so many beads and rods in the vertical format. Hence they made it horizontal so that it was portable for us. After it became horizontal, then there was a problem. Then unitary system came into place. But on abacus, all these points were not available. So if for me, my unit point is here, maybe for you, your unit point is here. So if I am calculating from here, you will not be able to calculate 4-5 rods if you start from here. Hence, they introduced the unit point in the abacus. After unit point was introduced, more and more evolution took place. Firstly, I think there were only 11 rods available, but then our knowledge of math and digits increased. So today there are 17 rods available, and on this abacus, there is no BODMAS operation that cannot be performed. Any math calculation can be done with the help of abacus. So that is how the full evolution of abacus has taken place. Now the abacus that we use is a Japanese abacus or the Soroban abacus. It is called Soroban abacus. So it started with the Roman abacus. Then Chinese came up with a better version of abacus. And now today the most handy abacus is Japanese. So the difference between Chinese and a Japanese abacus is they have 5 beads in the lower rods and they have 2 each on the upper rods. So that is the difference, but it makes the normal calculations are a little complicated. Hence, in India, we mostly use Japanese abacus. Now, talking about parts of an abacus. So, this is the tool. This is the whole tool. This frame, this outer border is called the frame. These are the rods. These are the lower beads, upper beads, and the separator. If no beads touch the separator, the value is zero. As and when the beads start touching the separator, the value of the numbers start coming. So if my one bead is touching, it is the value is one. Now every lower bead has the value of one, but it depends on the number system. So if it is on the units rod, it will be one. But if it is on the tens rod, it will be 10, and so on. And all the upper beads, the value is 5, but again it depends on the number system. So for the units place, it will be 5, then 50, then 500, and so on. Now the biggest question is why?
Okay.
The biggest question is why do abacus? Our main focus always when we listen about abacus is math, but math is a part of it. Due to abacus, our visualization increases. Their mental abacus is a very important part in our abacus training. So because of that, we start visualizing the beads. If today I ask you to draw abacus in the paper, I'm sure all of you will be able to draw. We know there are 17 rods, 8 this side, the middle one is the unit. All of us will be able to draw the abacus. Why? Because our visualization power has increased. Moving ahead, concentration. Obviously, looking at it, I cannot say, if I don't know anything, it's difficult for me to remember that this is 1, this is 10, this is 100. So you need the concentration to realize what each bead stands for. Then it is logical reasoning. As we know, both our hands are working together, hence our logic increases. Our creative mind as well as our the logical aspect, both are working together. So we are able to solve more logical problems because of this tool. Photographic memory, obviously, if you close your eyes and I tell a sum right now, you will be able to picture the sum as and when you see it in your books. If I say 4, add 5, less this, it will come in the way you've seen it in your books. Hence, we are getting, our photographic memory is developing as and when we are going ahead with the training. And last one is recall. So, our activities that we do, in a way, we are kind of recalling and remembering the numbers. The speed writing, the speed is so much that we have started keeping certain numbers in our mind as and when we write. Hence, our recalling power has been developing because of the tool. I hope it was
great.
You understood.
Great.